tip.
Evening.
All right, all you folks out of here!
Is 35 or more, romance can live, not need be over. That romance can live at 35 and after.
Oh, merciful God, I hope so.
Yeah?
Good afternoon. Miss Hannigan, is it?
Yeah.
I'm Lieutenant Ward of the 17th Precinct. We found your runaway. You!
For you in the recreation room.
Shoot,
you little beach fuzz. Shoot. Oh, thank you so much, officer.
She was in one of them Hoovervilles down by the docks. I had a mangy mutt with her, but he got away.
Oh, poor little pumpkin out there in the freezing cold with just this sweater. Oh, I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thank you so much, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you, don't ever let me hear that you run away from this nice lady again.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, officer. I'm gonna have your head for that! Next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953! Are you glad to be back? Huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie! Well, what's the one thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie, Miss Hannigan.
For what you've done, I could get fired! Have the Board of Orphans in here sticking in their noses! Oh, you're gonna pay for that! Stay.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah.
Oh, good. I'm Grace Farrell.
So?
And the New York City Board of Orphans suggested that.
Oh, Grace, I can explain everything. It wasn't my fault. It was Annie UC who just jumped in Bundle's laundry bag and then...
Miss Hannigan!
Oh! And I know I should have called Mr. Donatelli, but I just panicked and I called the police.
Miss Hannigan! I'm sorry, but I haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Wait a second, hold it. I get it, sister. If it's beauty products you're peddling, I don't need any. Get out!
Miss Hannigan, I am not peddling anything. I'm private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
The Oliver Warbucks.
Love the code! I read in Winchell's column that Oliver Warbucks was the world's richest unmarried man.
I wouldn't know. I don't read Mr. Winchell. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
An orphan?
Yes, an orphan.
You sure he wouldn't rather have a lady? I got 2 weeks coming. It's a joke! What sort of orphan did you have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, capital MISSIPPI, Mississippi.
And cheerful. Oh, age doesn't matter. Say 8, 9, 10, 11? Yes, 11 would be perfect. Oh, and I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers red-headed children.
11! A redhead!
Nope, I'm afraid we don't have any orphans like that around here.
What about that child right there?
Annie? Oh, you wouldn't want Annie. She's a drunk! And a liar! She's a drunk and a liar!
Yes, I'm sure she's a drunk and a liar. Annie? Come here. Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
Oh, I would love to. I would really love to.
Now hold it. You can have any orphan in the orphanage, but not Annie.
Why?
I just told you so.
Miss Hannigan, I assume this has something to do with that business about the laundry bin and the police. Perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans.
Look,
and sign it.
I'm an easy gal to get along with. I'll sign it. If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
It's Annie you get.
Oh, boy. So then if you'll just get her coat, I'll take her right along now.
She don't have no coat.
Well, then we'll buy her one.
A boy?
We'll go to Bergdorf's and get you a warm winter coat.
I'm getting a cow.
Come along, dear. Mr. Wilbuck's limousine is waiting.
Oh, I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it.
Hey, kids, I'm getting out of here for Christmas. I'll write to ya. Bye, kids.
Bye, Annie.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan, and season's greetings.
Yeah, season's greetings.
Him any moment.
Do you really live here, or is this a train station?
We really live here.
Oh, boy.
Mrs. Greer?
Yes, miss?
Has the carpet been put down in the dining room, Mrs. Greer?
Yes, miss.
And has the Steinway been materials?
Yes, miss.
Everything is in order, miss. Mrs. Pugh has prepared his favorite dinner.
New England clam chowder.
Wonderful.
Kentucky fried chicken.
Wonderful.
Idaho potato.
And?
Baked Alaska.
Fine.
It will be good to see Mr. Warbucks again.
Yes. 6 weeks is a long time.
Yes, miss.
Now, would everyone come here for a moment, please?
Quickly, everyone. Everyone, quickly.
Everyone, this is Annie, the orphan who'll be with us for the next 2 weeks for Christmas.
Miss?
Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
Gee, I really do love my new coat, Miss Farrell.
I'm glad, dear. Now, Annie, what do you want to do first?
The floors, I'll scrub them. Then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning while you're here.
I won't?
No, you're our guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now. Cecile will pick out all your clothes. Your bath is drawn by Mrs.
That's okay, I haven't got any toys anyway.
No finger will
6 weeks. Where the hell is everyone? Hello?
Sir?
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
How was your flight from Chicago?
Not bad. Took only 17 hours, and we only had to land 8 times. Now, first things first, has the painting arrived from Paris?
Yes, sir. They're just about to hang it now, sir.
I don't think so. Grace, the messages?
Yes, sir. President Roosevelt, he wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll call him back in the morning. Anyone else?
John D. Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, and Harpo Marx.
Ah, nothing urgent. What did Harpo want?
He didn't say.
Wait a minute. I think I could learn to like that thing. Hang it somewhere.
Yes, sir.
Mrs.
Pugh.
New England clam chowder.
Wonderful.
Kentucky fried chicken.
Wonderful.
And baked.
And I'm sorry, but I won't be having dinner tonight. I have far too much paperwork to get through.
Wonderful.
Grace, I'll need you for dictation.
Yes, sir.
Staff, it's great to see you. Great. Dismiss the staff.
Of course.
Grace, if you could get your notebook. Who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan who you invited to stay with us for the Christmas holidays.
Orphan? That's not an orphan. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I guess she'll have to do. So, Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
Your last name, child.
Oh, I'm just Annie, sir, Mr. Warbucks. I haven't got any last name that I know of.
Just Annie, huh?
Just Annie. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
I don't suppose you'd like to meet Babe Ruth.
Oh, boy, sure! Who's Babe Ruth?
Grace, we will start by going over the shipments of iron ore to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It is her first night with us, sir.
Your first night? Well, we must do something special. Nothing but the best. Annie, have a seat.
A movie!
Would you like to go to see a movie?
Gosh, sure, I'd love to, Mr. Warbucks. I mean, I've heard a lot about them, but I've never been to one.
Never?
No, sir.
Well, we've got to do something about that and do it right away. And nothing but the best for you, Annie. First, you'll go to the Roxy. And then to Ruppelmeyer's for an ice cream soda. And then a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly.
Grace, forget about the dictation until tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Instead, you'll take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
Nothing, sir. It's just... Aw, gee.
Don't you want to go to the Roxy?
No, I want to. It's just... I thought you were going to take me.
Me? Annie, I am far too busy.
Aw, gee.
Annie, I just came back from 6 weeks away on a tour of my factories, or what's left of them due to this damn depression. And when a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation...
No, I get it, Mr. Warbucks. I understand.
Mr. Warbucks, Bernard Baruch calling.
Ah. Hello, Barney. Yes, I got in about an hour ago. No, Detroit and Chicago. Factories shut down. My factories were shut down. Your damn... Your darn tootin'. No. When I'm not making money, nobody is. And gosh darn it, Barney, your pal Roosevelt has got to do something drastic. He's got to come up with a new approach, a new plan, a new something.